Benefits of going to the gym, but getting started can be a little intimidating. And if you don't know what you're doing, not only will you miss out on the benefits, you could hurt yourself in the process. Kim Fisher has the five most common gym mistakes that you should avoid.
McCall Wilson has been working with a trainer for a little over a year, and she says it's made a real difference in her workouts.
I have a ways to go, but definitely stronger and just have more energy.
McCall says before, she'd come up to the gym and just hit the treadmill.
I didn't know anything about weights, and I was scared of it.
Which is pretty common. Ray Lee is the head trainer at Diesel Fitness, and he says gym newbies make a lot of the same mistakes.
They kind of just take a look around, see what other people are doing.
But if you don't know what they're working out or why, not only will you miss out on the benefits, you may actually hurt yourself. So we're breaking down the five most common fitness mistakes, starting with weight.
If you use too light of a weight, then you don't get a real good burn.
And without the burn, you won't build strength.
But if you use too heavy of a weight, then it's the opposite end of the spectrum where you can end up hurting yourself.
And you lose form, which is mistake number two.
You see people kind of rocking.
Ray says you want to just use the muscles you're supposed to be working.
If you use proper form, then you can increase your strength that much faster.
So you get your form right, you have your weight right, but then you continue doing the same routine. That's another common mistake. You got to switch it up.
You always want to change up your workouts to always keep your body guessing. That way you can maximize the results that you get.
But before you get to that workout, you want to warm up for 10 to 15 minutes to get the blood flowing.
You know, the other part of warming up is not just getting your heart rate up, but it's also a good stretch.
And finally, if you don't know what to do, ask. Get started with someone who knows their way around a gym.
That's why a trainer is good. That's why a workout buddy is good, because that other person doesn't know what your limitations are, so they'll be able to push you a little bit harder.
If you can correct these five mistakes, Ray says you'll be on the right track.
And if you're new to a gym and you want to learn the basics, you may look into a few sessions with a personal trainer. The average session costs about $65 an hour.